Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the Bodoland Territorial Region Agreement. Now, this is important from your security subject point of view. So, there is a syllabus portion which talk about a security, and in that you discussed about the left-wing extremism, then the extremism in the northeastern state also. So, this comes under the extremism in northeast state and how the things have been lately. So, Bodoland Territorial Region Agreement is associated with that particular topic. So, let's start and try to understand what it is all about. So, BTAD, district is currently spread, which is basically your Bodoland Territorial Agreement area. In that, what all districts were there? Kokrajhar, Chirang, Baksa and Udalguri. So, these are the region. Kokrajhar, Chirang, Baksa and Udalguri, just remember these four names. Assam is celebrating the first anniversary of the historic Bodoland Territorial Region Agreement, and that is why this particular thing was in news, because it marks the first anniversary. So this agreement was signed in 2020. What this agreement was all about, let's just quickly see. So what is the 2020 Accord? So it provides for alteration of areas of BTAD and provision for Bodos outside the BTAD. Now the BTAD has been renamed to Bodoland Territorial Region. So this is, you can see over here, it was earlier BTAD, now it is BTR, and these are the area we just heard: Kokrajhar, Chirang, Udalguri and Baksa. So these are the four regions which are now part of the BTR, Bodoland Territorial Region. So this is something you should remember. Now what it will give? So this accord will provide more legislative, executive, administrative and financial power. So there will be the committee which will be managing this area will be having more legislative, executive, administrative and financial power to deal with the issues related to Bodo people. So let's just look at the terms and conditions of this particular agreement. So as per the agreement, villages dominated by the Bodos. So who are the Bodos? They are one of the ethnic group of Assam. Just remember it like that. They were present out that were presently outside the BTAD would be included, and those with non-Bodo population would be excluded. So this is what going to happen. So the villages which have Bodos in dominance or Bodos in majority would be included in the BTR, and the one which do not have the majority population of Bodos would be excluded. The memorandum of settlement says that criminal cases registered against the member of NDFB, which is National Democratic Front of Bodoland. So this was an organization which got really rogue and was associated with lot of killing, kidnapping and all these things. They were demanding Bodoland, but they were very aggressive in their approach. But by this agreement, actually it was a tripartite, which means it also included, apart from the center and other groups, it included the faction of NDFB also. The condition was they have to surrender, they have to give away their ways of aggression and violence, and they have to surrender. So that was the thing. So under this memorandum, it is like for the people against whom the non-heinous crime, the one who are arrested because of non-heinous crime, shall be withdrawn. So they could be withdrawn by the Assam government, and in cases of heinous crime, it will be reviewed. So the heinous crime where like murder and all these things is involved, these cases will be again reviewed, but the non-heinous one, they would be withdrawn by the Assam government. The families of those killed during the Bodo movement would be given rupees 5 lakh each. So this is again the term and condition of the agreement, that the Bodo movement, which was basically a movement to exert the dominance or exert the identity of Bodo people in Assam. So the people who have been killed during that time would be, their family would be given 5 lakh rupees each. A special development package of rupees 1500 crore would be given by the center to undertake specific projects for the development of Bodo area. So again, a development package has also been provided under the agreement. A committee will decide the exclusion and inclusion of new areas in the BTAD, or what we now are known as BTR. So what areas will be included, what will be excluded, that will be decided by a committee. Subsequent to this alteration, the total number of assembly seats will go up to 60 from the existing 40. So there were 40 assembly seats in the Assam. So after the alteration, it will go up to 60. So these are the terms and conditions of the agreement. Now let's just quickly see about a little bit of background. So first of all, Bodos are the single largest tribal community in Assam. So again, you must have known there are lot of tribes are there in the northeastern state. Assam is no different. It also has an amalgamation of lot of tribes. But Bodos are the single largest tribal community, which makes up to 5 to 6% of the state population. They have controlled large part of Assam in the past. So what is the Bodo line dispute all about and why the Bodo movement came into picture? So in 1966 to 67, the demand for a separate state called Bodo land was raised under the banner of Plains Tribal Council of Assam, a political outfit. So there was a claim that, like you must have heard, there is a claim these days about the Nagaland from the Nagaland side. So they talk about a greater Nagaland. Similarly, earlier in 1966-1967, there was a call for a Bodo land, a separate land in itself. Then in 1987, all Bodo land students union or APSU renewed their demand, which called for the divide Assam 50-50, which was given by their leader Upendranath Brahma. So Upendranath Brahma said that divide Assam 50-50, like 50 should come to the Bodo people itself. The unrest was a fallout of the Assam movement, which was in 1979 to 1987, whose culmination the Assam Accord addressed the demands and projection of safeguard for the Assamese people, leading the Bodos to launch a movement to protect their own identity. So this thing, the Bodo identity, came after the Assam Accord, which was signed in 1985, which was mostly for the identity of the Assamese people. So again, the Bodo people feel like their identity is still threatened. So they again started with the Bodo movement with very like a long standing and the involvement of NDFP, which is a political which is a rogue outfit, which actually went into the violence stream. All these things considered, that this agreement was considered a very landmark event, and it has actually helped to provide more autonomy to the Bodos people itself, and at the same time it has also kept Bodos within the territory of Assam. So in that regard, there is another thing that you should know, that the government of India has signed agreements with other states also. So there is an agreement with the regarding the Brew settlement, there is an agreement with the Nagaland also. So you have to go ahead and check about all these agreements which the government of India has made to quell the discomfort or to quell the anger of the people of the northeastern state. So this is the major thing that you need to know from here. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.